Hello, everyone. Thank you for your interest in the I Street Bridge Replacement Project. The project design team and I are really excited to share some ideas with you, and we're especially eager to hear your feedback as well. As you may know, the project will remove traffic from the upper deck of the existing I Street Bridge, and our new replacement bridge will be constructed just upriver to the north. And it'll align with Rail Yards Boulevard on the Sacramento side and tie into C Street on the West Sacramento side. So due to the necessary navigational clearances of the river, the main span of the bridge will be a lift span and will lift vertically to allow vessels to pass underneath. Along most of the main span of the bridge, it'll have a generous clear roadway width of about 52 feet, which is ample room for one vehicular lane in each direction plus a central turn lane. 6-foot bike lanes on either side are separated from traffic by a 2-foot shoulder buffer. On either side of the road, wide 12-foot pathways allow plenty of room for pedestrians, joggers, and slower cyclists. Now let's dig into the design for the project. We developed 9 concepts to show you today. The concepts fit within these 3 cost categories: low, medium, and high. In each category, we've developed about 2 to 4 alternatives. This first concept, the triangle, has its roots in the industrial styles of other types of truss bridges, but it has a few tweaks to make it a little bit more modern. For this design, the devil is really in the details. The idea is that the truss members will be simple, but they would be joined together using this new rounded gusset plate technology connection, which gives the bridge a much more contemporary and sleek vibe. For the second concept, we're taking that idea of a simple structure, but now we're taking it one step further by adding a really simple architectural skin. Each truss has been expanded to accommodate the full pathway, so people can really get up inside the structure, and instead of just being next to it, they can really inhabit the space. You'll have smaller spaces and bigger spaces, and the light will come through, and the structure itself will start to form the space, kind of like being inside of a nice cathedral. The third concept, the fold, is again a through truss bridge, but in this case the tower is kind of shrouded in this veil of vertical slats and louvers. It looks understated and elegant from afar, but it has a little hidden trick. And that is, when the bridge goes up, all the lattice louvers on the tower also fold up. The through truss over the roadway has a subtly changing pitch in the roof. So as you're driving through just on a day-to-day basis, you would get that kind of kinetic, almost bird wing-like movement hinting at you. The next concept, the flutter bridge, again is playing up this idea of a kinetic movement across the bridge. So here we have truss members that on either side of the roadway are subtly arced, but then the center cord down the middle is arced in the other way, so that we have this roof plane that's changing shape constantly as you're going through it. And this really is to create this nice porch-like amphitheater set of seating, and the trellis extends out over the top of that to provide a little bit of shade and make a nice sense of enclosure. The basic structural principle behind the garden bridge concept is that we have 2 twin trusses, similar to our through truss design earlier, but in this sense, instead of walking through those trusses, we inhabit them on top of them. The idea behind this concept is to take the excellent pathways along the riverbank and just carry them onto the bridge. The big architectural and engineering innovation here is the idea of putting plants on a movable bridge. Seeing plants move up and down, trees move up and down, has never been done before in the world, and it would definitely be a unique first. Spring is a basket handle arch concept. The idea behind this concept is to provide a nice, elegant structure that's also very transparent. So the arch is supporting the roadway with a series of cables, which essentially become transparent, especially when viewed from far away. Then on top of that, we want to still try and keep a lot of those great amenities that make a nice pedestrian experience. With the nest concept, we wanted to explore what would it be like if we made the main span of the bridge a jewel out on the river. We came up with this diagrid truss structure that arcs over the roadway. It's not an arch, it's not even really a truss. It's this crazy, innovative hybrid type structure. The way the light comes through those diagrid spaces is really dynamic and really quite engaging. It's almost like being inside a grand atrium. Flight is kind of a hybrid between an arch and a truss structure. We have ribs that are subtly increasing in height as you move towards the middle of the span. The shared use path for this structure goes out and around those towers. Then the path bends back up against the bridge structure at midspan to create kind of an amazing sense of place at the middle of the river there. The solar arch is the idea of one grand overarching awning structure, the metaphoric symbolism that it represents, this kind of unbroken line from one side of the river to the other side. So we have here is two arch systems nestled into each other. One is the overarching solar awning, and the other is the actual structural system of the lift span. We did add a really nice pedestrian and bike shared use path that dips down to almost feel like you're touching the river. So that's the quick description of all 9 concept alternatives that we developed for this round. It's a collaborative effort. Really, the public, you guys, the community are the other half of the puzzle. So I'd really appreciate any feedback that you could give us. And thanks again for listening. I look forward to working with you again at the next meeting.